encouraging us to be better and what we do, God. I'm asking for covering over so many people who are going through certain situations and circumstances, which we all are, God, but continue to help and continue to be there for them at all costs, God. So we give you glory, we give you honor, and we give you praise in Jesus Christ's name. Amen.
Amen.
Look, real simple. Today, the sermon, it's real simple. I don't want to take long trying to preach it, but I do want you to hear this. From Matthew chapter 8, verses 1 through 3. Matthew chapter 8, verses 1 through 3. Good morning to all of you. Thank you for joining. Matthew chapter 8, 1 through 3. Listen, this is what it says. It says, when Jesus came down from the mountainside, large crowds followed him. A man with leprosy came and knelt down before him and said, Lord, if you are willing, you can make me clean. Jesus reached out his hand and touched the man. And he said, I am willing, he said. Be clean. Immediately, he was cleansed of his leprosy. Now, I want to tell you that my title is, Can Jesus Make You Clean? Can Jesus make you clean? What are you talking about, preacher? Today, I want to discuss how Jesus cleansed a man of leprosy. But does he have a cure for your disease? I hear what you're saying already. Preacher, I don't know what you're talking about. I'm not sick. What are you talking about? What disease? Well, we're going to get to that. We oftentimes look at other people and think that they have some sort of problem. They sick somewhere in some kind of way. And they got some problems going on and some circumstances. And you saying, hey, you know, they need prayer. They need this. They need that. But we oftentimes miss the illness that is taking place in our own lives. Yeah, y'all not hearing me. We see it on some other people. We see what they're going through, but we're walking around as if we don't have any sickness. We are able to see everyone else's problems and issues and flaws, but our own leprosy, we cannot see. Well, let me tell you what leprosy means. First of all, I like to give the definition. Leprosy means a contagious disease that affects the skin, the mucous membranes, and the nerve, causing discoloration and lumps on the skin. And in severe cases, it can cause disfigurement and deformities. Listen to me good. The first thing that I want you to know is that this disease is contagious. Y'all go get it in a minute. This leprosy that the man had is contagious. And I want you to know, if you write this down for me, point number one, whatever your leprosy is, I want you to know that it is contagious. You'll get it in a minute. Although this man's disease was contagious, Jesus still didn't mind touching him. See, in those days, if you had leprosy, you had to live away from everyone else. And you could only live amongst people who had leprosy because they did not want the disease to spread to people who were already clean. Y'all gonna get this in a second. Like I said, the leprosy was contagious. Number one, whatever your leprosy is, it is contagious. One thing that really triggered me in this story, though, is the faith that this man had. This man had this faith. He was bold enough to stop everything that he was doing. He stopped everything that he was doing and everything that was going on in his life, and he kneeled down before Jesus. Point number two, write this down. Point number two, I need you to be bold enough to stop everything that's going on in your busy life and humble yourself to kneel down before Jesus. What preacher, what are you talking about? What are you saying? See, everybody wants to follow Jesus after he comes down from the mountainside and the glory of God is on him for miracles. And we want to follow him when we feel clean enough to be by him. But what I want to know, where are you when you don't feel clean? When you aren't clean? When you have a leprosy going on in your life? See, this man, he should not have even been mixed in with the crowd. Because he was dirty. What people would think, he was dirty with this contagious disease. But he snuck in the crowd some kind of way, from somewhere, and he kneeled down before Jesus because he needed something. He needed something. He actually told Jesus what he wanted. And he explained to Jesus that he was able to provide it. Now, this is what I call faith, is when you know what you need, and you know you got the faith that Jesus can provide it. Well, here's point number three. Tell Jesus what you want and explain to him how your faith makes it possible for him to provide what you need. God, that's what I tell God all the time. My faith ought to be strong enough, God, that you could possibly provide me with what I need because I have the faith. So tell Jesus what you want and explain to him how your faith makes it possible for him to provide what you need. See, the man wasn't worried about who was around him. He wasn't worried about that. Or who was going to say something to him. You know, some people, we always worried about what people going to say in the church. And we don't want to do nothing because we don't want folk in our business. You know, he wasn't worried about what folk were going to say about him and what he needed. He just knew that he needed something. And my point is, he knew where to get it from. Well, this is the problem nowadays. It used to be a time in our lives where we knew where our help came from. We just knew it. We knew how to get it. We knew what the Lord was doing. It's not like that anymore. This is why we have so much going on in the world right now, because we don't know who to turn to no more. You see, the problem is we think that we should be worried about this presidential election and who's going to be in office, and we need to be worried about the senators and the commissioners, but we forget who we need to rely on in the times of these kind of issues and sicknesses like these. I can't go to the president or to my local commissioner when I got some issues going on in my life. They can't do nothing about it. We don't call on the name like we used to. There are so many other options and people we think we can depend on. So we don't call on the name of Jesus anymore. We call on our friends and our cousins and our parents and our loved ones. And we try to get them to come, I need your help, I need your help. And when the first person I always think to call on is call on the name of Jesus. This I'm going to tell you the truth. This is why we have so many murders and senseless crimes. This is why we have so many suicides and early deaths. This is why we have so many broken homes and dysfunctional families. One of the reasons is because we don't call on the name of Jesus like we used to. We don't bow down before him when we have a leprosy problem. We don't do that. I remember, and I miss these days, my family, every Sunday, we would all sit down and eat and pray and eat together at the table. We just don't do those type of things. Everybody got something to do. Everybody got somewhere to go. And sometimes we be too many. And when I read the definition of leprosy, I begin to think of people that have deformities or disfigurements. But listen to me. I'm not talking about their hands and their arms. I'm not talking about their legs and feet. Here we go. I'm about to go spiritually. But I'm talking about people who are deformed in their minds. They're disfigured in their hearts. There's a leprosy of sickness brewing on the inside of some of us. In our attitudes, in our facial expressions. We oftentimes even have a choice of leprosy when we choose to disfigure our facial expressions, to always walk around and have a frown on our face or be angry all the time. I call this having a form of leprosy. I was wondering, I was asking Jesus, is this something that you can cleanse? Is this something that you can help the people with? I know the leprosy that the man had. See, we look at leprosy in a different light. But there are many of us walking around with our own leprosy problems. We're sick with a contagious disease. We're spread. Let me tell you how it's contagious. Remember when I went back up there and I told you, number one, whatever your leprosy is, it is contagious. But number two, I told you, be bold enough to stop everything that's going on in your busy life and humble yourself to kneel down before Jesus. And number three, tell Jesus what you want and explain to him how your faith makes it possible for him to provide. Well, when I looked at what leprosy was, some people are walking around with it and don't even know that they have this leprosy problem. We're sick with a contagious disease. What do you mean, contagious? What are you talking about, preacher? Some of us have hate in our hearts, and it's contagious. So we are spreading the hate we have. We are spreading the disbelief we have. We're spreading the anger we have, the gossip, the sins. I'm talking about leprosy that's contagious. Some people are walking around here, they like faking in church as if they really have this relationship with God, but they don't really know him at all. They just know how to do church really well. Church is, it's easy, it's church. Leprosy. Some people like to shout all around the church as if they really have the Holy Spirit deep down inside of them, when it's actually, it is a spirit, but it ain't the spirit we trust in. Leprosy. Some people like to be in everybody else's business. Always trying to get somebody else's business straight for them when they never have their own business straight for themselves. I call that leprosy. There are people who walk around living promiscuous lives. Just sleeping with everybody you want to. Any kind of person, back and forth, it doesn't matter. Some people who are thieves. Some people who are liars. Some people who are jealous hearted. Some people who are drunkards. Some people who like to curse other people out for no reason. And then turn around and speak the name of Jesus right out the same mouth. The Bible says that fresh water and salt water can't come out of the same faucet. And here we are. This is how we talk. I call that leprosy. All these people think that they won't have any repercussions for the sickness that they have, the leprosy problems that they're living with. But I want to tell you, in Galatians chapter 5, in 21, it says, "And envy, drunkenness, and orgies, and the like, I warn you, as I did before, that those who live like this will not inherit the kingdom of God." Oh man. And you know what? It gets me kind of nervous and scared, because I know so many good people that I love, and they live these type of lives, and the Bible says they won't inherit the kingdom of God. See, I have come to the conclusion that we have lost our everlasting leprosy minds. Yes. When you're sick with a contagious disease and you didn't lose your mind, we have just gone plumb crazy trying to do things on our own without him anymore. Without kneeling down. Without calling his name. We have been walking around here with a sickness that we can't even recognize that we have. We don't even know we're sick. But then we turn around and we're hoping that the world can heal us with their new revolutionary medicines. Preacher, what do you mean? Revolutionary medicines. Medicines that will say that wrong is right and right is wrong. I'm talking about those type of medicines. They're like, heal yourself. This ain't, do what you want to do. Medicine that say it's your thing. Do what you want to do. Medicine that say it's okay to sin because God will forgive you of them. But I stopped by here today to ask you a question. Do you believe that Jesus can make you clean? This one, I don't know if we live this way where we have enough faith to say that, you know what, Jesus can take this problem away from me that I've been having a long time. I haven't gotten rid of it because I don't know how, so I walk around with it. I walk around with this leprosy. I walk around with this anger in my heart. I walk around this frown on my face. I walk around in doubt. I walk around in depression. I don't know how to get rid of this leprosy. Have you been in this condition too long to recognize that you are sick? You have a leprosy that has been contagious to others. Yeah. You're not hearing me. You've been doing it, and there's people who have been around you, they love you, and they're trying to stick with you. Now it's being contagious. You're pushing that kind of thinking off on other people. You make other people think it's all right to walk around with a bad attitude. That's contagious. You make other people think that it's all right to go to the palm reader for their answers. You ain't got to consult God anymore. The palm reader can tell you right then. Oh, you got this. Oh, that's a money sign there. Oh, this, they don't connect. Oh, you know what? You're going to get married soon. You know what? You make people think that it's all right to live a life of sin with fornication and adultery. As long as you don't get caught, you all right. You all right. That's what people think. You make people think that it's all right to lie. I know so many people, they be lying for no reason. They lie about the littlest thing. And you be like, what was that for? Lie about anything and everything. Just as long as you get your way, you gonna lie. And nobody gets hurt. Well, what are you saying, preacher? What are you saying? I'm saying you're sick. It's some people got a disease. You have leprosy. There's a leprosy problem, and you need to kneel before Jesus so he can cleanse the problem. This is a simple sermon. It ain't gonna take long. What are you saying, preacher? Can Jesus cleanse me? Can Jesus make me whole? Can Jesus make you clean? I want to know if he did it for the leper, man, that was sick with the skin disease, the mucus membrane. Can he do it for you? The answer is yes. He can heal you. The answer is yes. He can make you clean. The answer is yes. He is the only one we can count on to cleanse us from our leprosy problems. Whatever they might be. I don't know what your leprosy may be. Your leprosy might be that you like to be depressed all the time. Your leprosy might be that you like to cuss a lot, smoke a lot, drink a lot. I don't know what it is. I ain't saying you're going to hell for none of it. But I'm saying if you stay in this condition, you're going to stay sick. You're going to have this leprosy problem, and it's going to be contagious. The answer is yes. He can make a way. He can heal you. Yes, I want you to know you are contagious. But I want your contagiousness to be for healing of other people's spirits. Let it be a contagiousness of a smile on somebody's face when they see you and you being kind. Let it be a contagious, encouraging word that makes someone want to be better. Lord, I want to be better. Let it be contagious that someone knows that you love God. Most of the time, some people that go to church or say they love God, people can't tell it because you're carrying around a different leprosy that they can't even see God over your life. Contagiously spread the word of God by how you live. I ain't saying by what you say. I ain't saying you got to run down the street shouting, doing flips and all. No. Encourage others. Be contagious by how you live. And let this spread like a disease. Like a disease of leprosy that will reverse sickness and heal the land. What is your leprosy problem? And will you let Jesus cleanse it for you? It's time out for us to keep walking around here in a sick condition, waiting for other people of the world to try to help us with circumstances and situations that they have no control over. It's time to kneel down before Jesus. It's time to speak to him. Call his name out. He's come down from the mountaintop. He's come down and you have access to him if you would just kneel down and ask him, Lord, if you are willing. This is what the man said. If you're willing. Jesus wants me to tell you, yes, I am willing. Be clean. Can Jesus make you clean? Yes, be clean. Immediately, this man was cleansed of leprosy. And if he did it for him over 2,000 years ago, he can do it for you. He can just reach out your hand to him. He doesn't care what your leprosy is. He doesn't care how contagious it might be. Let's work on this contagious disease that's affecting our membranes and our nerves and the way we think and the way that we live and what's in our heart. Let's work on it. Number one, whatever your leprosy is, it's contagious. Change that around. If you're going to be contagious to people, let it be out of love and peace. And number two, be bold enough to stop everything that's going on in your busy life. Humble yourself and kneel down before Jesus. Number three, tell Jesus what you want. That's what the man did. Explain to him, Jesus, my faith makes it possible for you to provide what I need. This is what we're working off of. Jesus is able to cleanse whatever is going on in your life. Now, the reason we have to preach these type of sermons, I know, I wish I could preach about money all the time and how God can make a way for you. But the reason we preach these type of sermons is because of Romans chapter 10, verse 9, that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth and believe in thy heart that God has raised him from the dead, then thou shalt be saved. I want you saved, but I want you living a clean life. I want you living a prosperous life, not walking around with this leprosy sickness that you got going on. And I have a song I want to play for you. The song doesn't belong to me. Originally, it was sung by Marvin Sapp. But today, I picked up the version of Leandra Johnson saying, never would have made it. I want you to know that we never would have made it if it wasn't for Jesus, if it had not been. And we got a lot more to go, and I want to depend on him. So listen to this song and be encouraged. Never Should Have Made It by Leandra Johnson.
Never would have made it. Never could have made it. Without
Song, but listen, I just know that we never could have made it if it hadn't been for Christ. Listen, if you want to be a blessing to the church, you can give to our Cash App at @HIGHERGROUNDCC and be a blessing. Can Jesus make you cleanse? Yes, he can. He can change anything in your life. He can change anything in your family's life, anything in your kids' life, anything in some people around you who are having a problem. He can cleanse that. He can make you over again. Listen, I appreciate you taking the time. I'll be back on Tuesday just to give a refresher on this, just to let you know that Jesus is able and he is willing. Let's pray. Lord, I thank you for your word. Thank you for your love. Thank you for your kindness. Thank you for caring about us, God. Thank you for what you do for us, God. Thank you for what you're going to do, God. Continue to bless us. Continue to watch over us, God. It's in your darling son, Jesus Christ's name, we pray. And we give it all to you. Amen.
Amen.
Listen, y'all enjoy the rest of your day, and we'll talk to you later.